Hi, and welcome to episode 6 of EFS TV. I'm Nathaniel Decker.
And I'm Megan Osisko.
And we are excited to have you guys today. We're going to do things a little bit differently. We've been doing the traditional, you know, you guys send in your questions, we'll answer those. It's been going really, really well, and we really love doing that. However, there have been some trends in the questions that we're receiving from clients and just other people that we talk to as well.
Time of year.
Yeah, the time of year and just different things like that that come up. Especially now that it's starting to warm up, but we're in Cleveland, Ohio, so it's tricking us. It's 71 week, it's snowing the next. Mm-hmm. So a lot of trends in the questions and stuff we're getting, we want to address some things today on our own, and then we'll get back into the traditional Q&A probably next week. So
cool.
What are some of our topics?
So a lot of questions coming up, especially from my clients. We're kind of hitting that, you know, we're 4 months into the year, everyone started off with a really good kick of their New Year's resolution. So now it's kind of sticking to that. So some people are kind of getting a little discouraged. Like you said, the weather doesn't really help, you know, with the highs and lows all the time. So how do we overcome the plateaus that we're starting to hit?
Right. Yeah. And that's a good point. I feel like plateaus are tricky because, first of all, they are normal. Everybody hits them. I have them. Megan has them. Everybody on our team has plateaus. They do happen. It's important not to let that get to you too much. So don't let that drag you down and stop you from reaching your goals. At that point, it's just time to address the things that you're doing and change it up. The biggest part of that, I think, for me is just tracking what I'm doing. It's really hard to take a look at everything you've been doing over the last few weeks and say, all right, I'm going to do this differently, unless you've been writing things down, workout to workout, meal to meal, so that you know what you need to change. And a lot of times, just putting pen to paper, you kind of realize, like, oh, crap, like, right. I see where I'm going wrong now. Right. I need to fix this. Yeah, right. So what would you add to that?
Definitely reevaluating where you're at. I think that's a constant thing, you know, week to week, day to day of what you're doing. So either you're going to need to switch up, you know, the intensity of your workouts is always a key thing. The intensity of your cardio, possibly, or increase the, you know, amount of cardio you're doing throughout the day, throughout the week. And then nutrition, we talk about that a lot. You know, are you, you know, cutting your carbs out after 5 p.m.? Are you, you know, adding in enough protein throughout your, throughout your day?
Yeah, I think a big point too is pay attention to what you're looking at and what you're judging that off of. Some people get on the scale and they say, all right, it hasn't moved at all. I've hit a plateau. Yeah. But at the end of the day, if you're getting stronger, if your endurance is getting better, there's so many different things that you need to be tracking to make sure that you actually are at a plateau and you're not just seeing benefits in other areas.
Yeah, and last thing is just, like we've talked about this countless times, is just the consistency. So, you know, are you leading a healthy lifestyle? Are you happy with, you know, your, obviously moderation is key of, you know, certain things, but are you day-to-day consistently, you know, eating clean, getting in your workouts, all of that? So stay the course.
Yeah, I think that's a good point. And always, as far as the course goes, always choose one that's going to be a little bit more sustainable for you, too. Don't do something that takes your life and turns it upside down. You know, a good point that I always make to clients when we first start with them, and I apologize for my voice today, it's a little raspy. When we first start with clients, I always tell people, first of all, if they eat healthy, great, that's a good starting point. But if you're somebody that doesn't eat healthy and you've never worked out before, we're going to focus on exercise first. We're not going to do anything with your diet until we get the exercise portion down. Because if you take your whole life and flip it upside down to see what sticks, you're not going to be successful unless you're like in that top 1% of people that take it very seriously. Mm-hmm. So
definitely. Cool. All right. So let's move on to the next topic. A lot of people are traveling still kind of off of spring break, longer car rides, extended time on a plane. What can people do?
Yeah, that's a good point. This is actually, my girlfriend actually made this point to me the other day. We had just drove back from Florida, which is from Ohio. It was a very long drive. And I don't
with
know.
With a dog.
Yeah. With a dog, a very oversized dog. Basically another person. And it's a good point because, you know, every 2-3 hours you get out of the car, you have to get gas, food, stop at a rest area. But things to do to keep active so you're not sore. I mean, my legs were cramped for like 2 days after I was done driving that, so it was terrible. But my tips were jumping jacks, do some stretches, things like that whenever you get out of the car. Go for a walk instead of just going to the restroom and straight back to the car to keep driving. But when you're driving that distance too, it's important to keep it moving. So I was kind of like, all right, let's get out, stretch out a little bit, and then back in the car we got hit the road. So what about you for traveling clients?
Do you have any tips? So obviously on an airplane there are regulations as far as like keeping your seatbelt on and that right. kind of stuff. But you know, take a lap just if you need to, you know, especially when they do turn off the no seatbelt sign.
Right.
It's good to get up and get those legs moving, like you said, the cramping, just get the blood flowing.
Right. And actually when you're at that altitude, it's actually healthy for you to get up and get moving. You're supposed to get out of your seat about every hour, hour and a half, mm-hmm. For those of you that don't know that. The traveling aspect is important. Obviously, there's a lot of people traveling right now, but it kind of got us thinking too, you know, outside of just traveling, people who work a desk job. Mm-hmm. So, and there's a lot of those. If you're sitting at a desk all day at a computer or in a conference room, whatever the case may be, get up and move. Mm-hmm. At least every, I know you
top
said like
of
top of the hour is a good one, every like every other. Hour. Mm-hmm. Just take a quick lap, go to the water fountain, go to yeah. the restroom, walk around, say hi to some people that you don't get to see very often. I know that people have to do that within the
right
within the rules of their office. But yeah, just get up and get moving. It's important to make sure you keep good blood flow throughout
right.
the day.
Yeah,
so
definitely. Yeah.
It's good for brain function too. Just a side note.
And so this, we kicked off our fit challenge last week. So, you know, things are going well. I think we got all of our weigh-ins for everybody. We wanted to give you guys our top three tips for kind of starting off.
Yeah, so I would say the first tip that I always give to people that are weight loss clients, addressing the diet, whenever it does come to addressing the diet, the first thing that I like to say is cutting carbs out after 5 p.m. You referenced that earlier. Mm-hmm. The reason that's important, and I do want to make sure that I cover this as well, the reason why that's important, if you look at about probably 75 to 80% of the people that I come across, if you take a look at their diet and what they're eating and when they're eating it, most people eat most of their carbs at dinner. Mm-hmm. So they're at work all day, you know, they're busy, busy, busy. They get home at 5 o'clock. They eat dinner with a lot of carbs, and then they go to bed.
Mm-hmm, right.
And that's where people are messing up. Mm-hmm. So if you're going to have carbs, eat them in the morning with your breakfast. Mm-hmm. So seal-cut oats, mm-hmm. things of that nature. It's usually what I have.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Sweet potatoes. It's not to say you can't have pasta or you can't have carbs. Eat that stuff for lunch.
Mm-hmm.
Give yourself the rest of the day to get that burn off, and you're not just laying down, going to sleep, and then storing all that as fat overnight.
Right. Yeah,
so that's, agree with that's that my
one.
Tip there.
My tip would be kind of smaller, frequent meals throughout the day. So obviously portion control is going to be huge with that because I'm not telling you eat 6 meals,
right.
huge meals a day.
Right.
So, I mean, I know it's when I need to eat. It's every 2 to 3 hours. Mm-hmm. And I can tell because my metabolism is going all day and I'm just constantly moving. So I need energy to build back up.
Right. And then cardio for 30 minutes, two to three days
yeah.
a week. I mean, cardio is, it's important for everybody too. It doesn't matter if you're trying to gain muscle, lose fat,
mm-hmm.
heart health is always yeah. important. You always have to address that stuff. It's something that I've actually recently done myself. I run about 2 miles, 3 days a week. It is not easy. It was not easy to get started, but it's very important.
Yeah. And it doesn't have to be intense. You know, like we said, sometimes we have the nicer days.
I jog. It's nothing intense.
Sometimes we have the nicer days. Go outside and just get moving. That's the most important thing.
Right.
You know, get started.
Yeah. And I think, you know, that's a big point that I kind of want to close today's segment with is taking action. So I feel like a lot of times speed is more important than taking your time to think and the quality of the process, right? Obviously, it's important that you're doing the right things when it comes to exercise and nutrition. But at the end of the day, if you got down on the floor right now and did 100 push-ups or 100 sit-ups, you're burning more calories than what it's going to take to sit down and plan out the next 6 months. So a good plan is okay. But it's always better to move fast with a good plan than to wait on a perfect plan. And that's definitely a point that I want to make. Taking action is going to get you guys there a heck of a lot faster. And I think of all of our Fit Challenge tips, that's going to be the big one. Take action right now. So.
Go do some push-ups.
Yeah, go do some push-ups. Sit-ups right now. Drop down. We're not those kind of trainers typically, but drop down and give me 50. So that's pretty much it for today's episode. You know, we wanted to address things a little different today. We do get a lot of questions from clients, but like we said, these ones within a trend were kind of all about the changing weather, the traveling, things like that. We wanted to come ourselves, address those, and then we'll get back to the Q&A stuff probably next week or the week after because I think we're doing an interview next week. So stay tuned for that.
All right,
guys. Enjoy the recipe, and we'll see you next week.
See you guys.